suppose fire this command UE print admitted, and it's showing the current users on the network on a particular cell. This is a site ID of the particular site, and these are the UEs. So currently 58 UEs are latched with cell ID 10, 22 UEs are latched with 17, and how many barriers they are using, how many services they are using. For cell ID 10, 106 services are used by this. These are UEs, 58 UEs. So by this, we can check our UE print admitted means the high load or overload condition. Hardware issue can be affect. This is the fourth point, hardware issue. If the site is having hardware issue, it can be affect our accessibility. Like suppose the site is having faulty antennas, faulty RRUs, faulty BBUs, then it can be affected. We can do one thing. First, we will restart the site. If it is eliminated by that, then it is okay. Otherwise, we will change the hardware. We can suggest to change the hardware, like change the RRUs, change the auxiliary unit like that. And LGD, we can type LGD. 1D means 1 day or 2 days. How many days we have? We want to see that. We can check it like that. Like suppose we are in the same way we are checking the alarm. We can check the LGD command. So this is about the hardware. Uplink interference. Interference is nothing but the external noise we are getting. External noise we are getting from in the network. Like we have two type of interference. One is external, one is internal. So external sources like repeater, airport, power plant, etc. Like we are in minister, near about minister's house, we are capturing jammers. So they are interfering in our network. In tent area, we have the jammers. So they are also interfering our network. So these are all the external sources. Internal sources, suppose our fibers are leaking the connections, antenna port, fiber cables, connectors. They are not connecting goodly, or they are not tightly connected. So our signal will be lost, and they are interfering our signal. So it cannot be happened. It ranges from -119 to -110. If it is going beyond that, then there is a problem. So I'll show you what is that interference. This is the radio REC interference PUCSA power, and it is showing on. See the values -119.7, 119.5. All these values, they are all in range. If it is going beyond 10, means 1110 or 118 or 108 or 107, like that, then there is an interference in that, and we need to eliminate it by escalating it to the OIM. PCI config. PCI is a physical cell ID. Physical cell ID is nothing. We are setting a physical cell ID on every cell, and we have around 504 physical cell IDs in LTE. And we cannot give the same cell ID to the neighboring cells, because it will interfere in our network. We can give like 5 to 4. We can make a distance of 5, 6, 7, 8 kilometers. After that, we can repeat our PCI, but beyond that, we cannot. So we have two type of PCI configs, which is called PCI confusion, and one is PCI collusion. So PCI confusion is UE is confused if it is getting two or more target cell and interference. Suppose I am a source PCI, source cell, and I need to hand over to a target PCI, and I am getting two target cells, and they are having same PCI like 502 502. So I'm confused that on which 502 I need to hand over it. So this is same like I am Ram, and I need to meet Sham at a particular location in Jama Masjid. Suppose in Jama Masjid I need to meet Sham, and the Sham is I need two Shams, so I do not know who Sham is this. So this is the same thing. So PCI collusion is the UE is collusing due to the source and target having the same PCI. Suppose my PCI is 102, and the target PCI is also 102. So I'm confused, like I do not know how to handle it. So PCI confusion is not there. Same as RATCH root sequence, we need to give a RATCH root sequence index to every site, and it should be unique. It should not be repeat, but it can be repeat on a minimum interval, like 5 kilometers or 10 kilometers, like that. We cannot give on constantly next cell the same batch root sequence. UE camping on the wrong cell means we cell reselection parameter need to be, means we are setting a priority on every technology, on every cell. We are giving a priority. It is from 0 to 7. 7 is the highest priority and 0 is the lowest priority. For I need to hand over to a particular technology. Suppose I need to hand over to GSM or to 3G. So I need to give the priority 7 for that. I do not want to hand over to a GSM, so I have to give the 0 priority for that. So this is the priority. We need to set the correct priority. So if we're talking about the Sprint network or AT&T network, so LTE to AT&T network, they are giving 7 priority. LTE to CDMA network, they are giving 2 priority, and LTE to GSM, they are giving 0 priority, like that. So here it is the command cell selection priority. We can check what is the cell selection priority of the cell. Wrong system constant. System constant is nothing that the wraps we are using. So we need to set the system constant as per the RNT CIQ or network design. VSWR overthrow short. VSWR is nothing but the voltage standing wave ratio. It is something called we can say that its value depends on the its value. I will show you. This is the VSWR. This is the command for the VSWR. IHRUFUG get VSWR values 18, 21, 13, like that. If it is goes beyond 10, or if it is go above 40, then that this is the problem for me. It's always in the DB. And why this VSWR will happen? It is basically the error in the side, like we have a faulty jumper, faulty connectors, faulty cables, like that, due to which we are getting the VSWRs. And this the one on the main thing is the cell availability. Cell availability need to be 100%, means cell do not goes down. If a particular site goes down or it is having power failure, so at that particular moment, whatever the calls is going on, they are all get dropped, and I cannot able to access the network also. If I want to access the network and it suddenly fluctuate or having the power backup failures, so these are S1 and EREV failures also. We will go in depth, and then I will tell you what is the reasons between for these RRC, S1 and EREV failures. So main reason for accessibility due to the time constraint, I'm just mentioning this accessibility is problem. We go on the retainability. The second KPI is retainability is to retain a network. When we are getting accessibility, we can latch on the network. Then we are getting the resources to do the call, to do the PS session, to use the internet. Then we can maintain that. If it is cut by their own, then that is a drop, and we cannot entertain drop in our network. Drop can be minimized. Drop need to be minimized in our network, as per the TRAI or as per any operator. So it defines as the ability of the user to retain ERAP. In that we read that to get ERAP, and now we need to retain ERAP. Once connected for the desired duration. So this is the formula for the ERAP. It is abnormal E0P at PM. ERAP abnormal means whenever the abnormal word is come, then there is a drop. And if normal is come, then it's a normal cut call. Okay, so we do not see that. So abnormal is something which is dropped. It is ENOT Act, MME Act divided by PM session time U. This is for the drop, and this is the formula for the retainability. So the major reason for the accessibility is poor coverage, alarm, high load, high traffic. So if the cell is loaded, like all these features, all these things I explained you above only, poor coverage also, alarm also, high load, hardware issue. If it is high hardware issue, then we need to replace the hardware, or first we will do the side reset. If it is gone, then it's okay. Otherwise, we need to replace the hardware. PSWR over threshold, PSWR should be in the range. And now this is something new from the accessibility part. It is called HO failures, handover failures. Handover is nothing. Then we are mobile. We are moving somewhere from one cell to another cell. Then we are handing over our calls from one cell to another cell. So that we get seamless network coverage. So our transition will be seamless. Like we do not get any handover failures. If we are getting any handover failures, then our call will be dropped. So that should not be happen in the network. If the sector is having high HO failures, it results in a poor retainability. I told you what is handover failures is, and how we will eliminate them. This is the counter for the handover failures. We can check that. Also, on the MME side also, we are getting the handover failures. If we are getting 100% and I have around 100 calls is going on, and they are simultaneously all the 100 calls call drop. So this is the MME issue, not the site issue, because site cannot able to drop all the calls at one time. MME can does. So there is a problem in the MME, so we need to check the MME. So maybe the MME problem is there. We need to concentrate on one cell, and we need to give coverage of one cell only. And high uplink interference is there, and repeaters problem sometimes. So this all will become in the execution failures. Now the UE loss, the main reason for the drops to be happening is the UE loss. UE loss is happening because of the poor coverage. Most of the time you will note down this counter only, UE loss. A major of the drop is happening in this UE loss. Over here it is written total number of abnormal ENOT be released by the ENOT be percent due to the contact with the UE is lost. Means from the network to UE, the contact is lost. So the reason is poor coverage. We can eliminate that poor coverage by doing the physical optimization like tilt, azimuth, proper parameter settings like that. Like we are giving the part of sector power, means power of the increase the power of the cell, and then we will radiate that with the radiative mode. And P0 nominal PUCH, P0 nominal PUSCH for the uplink coverage. These are parameters we can tune. Uplink interference issue is the main, this is one of the main reasons in the IT network for having the poor KPIs. Like all the KPIs are impacting if we are having interference. So this is the UE loss, and then the license issue. PM ERAB abnormal release ENOT LIC. LIC is the license. So license must be activated. Every feature is having license of that. If the license got expired on a particular cell, then we need to, we got alarm for that, and then we got drop for that. So license must be activated. This is the TN failure. TN failure is nothing but transport resource unavailable, transport failures. It is happened because of the core network down or issues with the S1 interface or X2 interface, which are connecting via MME or to the different modules. X1 and X2 interface of that only. So we can eliminate that by escalating it. Means we cannot do it by own. We can escalate it by ONM team or NOC team. they can eliminate it. So now the sixth part is E0B at HPR. HPR is handover preparation phase. In the preparation only our drop is happening. This is the reason, this is the main cause. So MME missing issue, MME might be disabled, transport issue suspected, license issue suspected, cell site configuration issue. These are the four main points for the handover preparation phase. So all these all counters will be tagged when we are analyzing the drop, why drop is happening. Over here I show you all, this is ACT HO. HO is over here, ACT HO. This is the ACT HO execution phase. So if you can see that this is the rock wise data, means 15 minute data was for every cell. This data is for the 2 hours. So four rows is one hour and four rows is for the 1 hour. So if you are seeing 1, 2 over here, 1, 1, and that means these are the drops that in this 15 minute one drop is happening. In this 15 minute one drop is happening. So it is minimum, means when 500 call is going on at a particular time and one is dropped, then that means nothing will be harming it. It can be happened. So 1, 2 drop is okay, no problem, no issues. This is CDT. CDT is cell downtime. No call is happening that because this is happening because of site fluctuation. This is UE's. Nature of the drop we are getting in this category only, UE loss. And you just see 3, 2, 3. Constantly we are adding drop in. In every drop we are getting the drop in. So we need to eliminate that. This is happening due to the poor coverage. And we can optimize it. Okay. Now you can see that 5 drop is happening. This 3 drops like that. Okay. Now we have at HPR and at TN phase. This is the preparation phase and this is the transport network phase. So 0 is everywhere. Now we come on the mobility section. Mobility is nothing. Then we are doing the handovers. So we need to do the seamless mobility. We are over seamlessly, we do not get any interruption in the services. So we have three type of mobility is divided into three parts. One is reporting, one is preparation, one is execution. Reporting is nothing, just we have some events with us by which we are doing the handover. So event A3 is pegging in the reporting phase, means we are going to hand over to some other cells. My source cell's coverage is not that good and I need to hand over it. So this is reporting. Preparation is sending a request to the target cell to perform the admission control to maintain all the services on the target node. This is called the preparation phase. And execution is after preparation, after successful preparation, source should not be sent the handover command. Means after all the admission requests will happen, then the execution will happen. Means my all resources will be shifted to the target E0B. Now the source E0B will be cut down. Okay, so this reporting will, we cannot see this reporting part, but these are the main two reasons for the mobility to be dropped. One is preparation, one is execution. And my mobility formula is made up of the preparation and execution only. On the above side, you can see that it is all the preparation part. And success and the lower part is attempt. Over here also it is success attempt. It is for the it is for the preparation and it is for the execution. Preparation, execution. So these are the main cause for the preparation failures. MME pool should be same. The MME pool is UE is latching. I told you that we have one MME by one MME several E0Bs is connected. So it should be on the basis of network design. You cannot do it manually if it is not putting on a network design. So at that time preparation phase is like, we are typing a command turn point to MME. We are getting the values over here 19, 20, 21, 22. So it is based on the design document. Whatever we the operator design, we need to give these values. We cannot give it manually or by our own. So this is PID where byteless is active on the side, which is PLMN, primary PLMN set to 2. This is, if we are saying this, this is the primary PLMN reserve. So if you see that some for some cell it is false, and some cell it is true. So true are the cells which are not live, and false are the cells which is live in the network. So if I want to hand over on the true cell which is not live, then I can't able to do it because they are not live. They are just a demo site, and we need to launch it. So we cannot hand it over. So this is the main reason for the preparation. On the true cell, it cannot be happen. So target the cell is overloaded. Side means target cell is not overloaded. I discussed that earlier also. Target cell is unavailable means availability problem on the target cell, which cannot be happen. Tag is not defined on the side as per the RLT. Tag is nothing but the tracking area code. We are giving a tracking area code on the particular size, like we make a bunch of like 100 side or 50 side and make a tracking area. On that only we define a side. So I'll show you, like this is the one, this is the tag. Tag is depends on the RND CPI. If suppose my one cell is on different tag, then there must be a problem that handover failures will happen. So license issue, software issue, target cell is faulty, site configuration issue. These are the main reasons for the execution. ANR, PCI conflict confusion did not happen. Target cell is in cell range, means if it is going cell range, we are defining in LT, we are defining a cell range. If our cell is 15 kilometer, if my target cell is beyond 15 kilometer, then we cannot able to access that. Target is a sleeping cell. We need to wake up that cell by restarting it if it is a sleeping cell. So a sleeping cell issue will not be happen on the target cell. Target is a high uplink interference. So uplink interference is the main reason, poor coverage and interference. These are all the main reasons for the handover issues preparation. Here comes the next part, is integrity throughput. Integrity throughput is service integrator represent the quality experienced by the end user during the call, or if we are using internet, then we can get the good throughput in there. So there are three aspects of the integrity. One is latency, one is throughput, one is packet loss. So latency is the time is taken to schedule the first packet on the air interface. You can determine the time it was received in the RDS. Suppose I'm using my phone. I'm giving you an example. If I'm using my phone camera to taking a selfie. So if I move my head here and there, then how much time it will take to reflect in the camera itself. So by this, this is the same thing we are using in the latency also. If I gave a command over here in my laptop, then how much time it will take to process on the different ends. So this is the thing in the latency part. So latency should be less. Throughput is the speed at which the packet can be transferred once first packet and schedule in the air interface. So throughput must be high. Packet loss, the rate of congestion related packet loss. The packet that get dropped due to the active queue management functionality, and those are the packet get lost in the transmission. For example, discard of the sub link layer means the packet, whatever packet we are sending in the network, that must be received in the network also. It not be got dropped anywhere in middle. So these are the points, and to get the good throughput, we are having these points. We need to do the audit of the our parameters. All the parameters are set as per the network design. Whatever network design operator set on that only, And Elode V is using ditch MIMO options. Like we have 2x2, 4x4. Beyond that, we have 16x16 and 64x64 also in 5G. So we can use that to get the throughput high, hard, and radio environment also plays a significant role, like CQI, SNI, link adaptation. Mobility in the cell should not be neglecting tongue or fluctuating or doing the constant handovers. And E2E dimensions like E-Node is active on user cell, means active E-Node resource carriers are there. Backhauls is also maintained. Core network issues may be happen, IP delay, routing, packet loss, session performance, and our use should be also in good health. So these are all the reasons for that. So if I talk about this, what you will get from this course, you can enter in any of the domain, like RF planning, RF integration, RF optimization, and O&M, project manager, protocol development and testing. And by you are getting the knowledge of this LTE. In this session, in all these sessions, all the basic stuff on the LTE, like all the technology, handovers, MIMO, all that thing, so that you can crack any interview and you can get a chance into like work in any of the agencies like Ericsson, Nokia, Huawei, like that. So this is from my end. You can ask anything if you want.